The short answer, no. The long one, it depends, but let me explain. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Patrick from ProgrammerGoals.com, and today let's answer the big question: do you need a computer science degree to become a developer? Now, first, what kind of developer do you want to be? A software developer, a game dev, web, app, anything else? There are many possibilities, but your journey can be quite similar either way. I did actually study computer science. I got my bachelor's and my master's degree, and then I wanted to become a game developer. And then, in fact, I got a position in a game dev studio, and then after experimenting with some other industries, I'm now a back-end web developer. I love it, but I still like to make games by myself in my spare time. If I had to decide today if I want to go to university again, I'm not that sure if I really would do it. The time after my graduation taught me one thing. Nowadays, there are so many more possibilities. For starters, you could try to get an internship to get a glimpse at a certain job. Or if you're already sure, you could, for instance, apply for an apprenticeship. Apart from that, there are many, many boot camps, for instance, where you could learn the craft of software development in a few months instead of several years. But let's have a look at the advantages of studying computer science. You get an overall look. You may start with assembler, then learn C, C++, Java, maybe even C sharp. You also learn a lot of theory and math, and you can also take other interesting courses like IT security, design patterns, and so on to get deeper understandings in all these topics. But that's nothing you couldn't learn in another way. For me, the computer science degree was mainly the ticket into the tech industry. You've got a master's degree? Great. You should already know this and that, but the most important fact is you were able to finish a project over several years. This one is crucial. For several years, you were able to focus on this one single thing, this one big project, and you have even finished it. This skill is very important in this industry. It shows that you have the patience and the persistence to focus on this one project. Big companies like Google, for instance, seem to absolutely want you to have a degree, but not only any degree. You need perfect grades, and ideally, you have studied at a famous university. But even then, they will test you with several coding interviews. And after graduation, it's all about your experience and your references. For me personally, it was a big advantage that I have published an indie game, for instance, and made some online courses. People could actually have a look at my skills without the need to talk to me. Fun fact, a company that invited me to an interview actually bought one of my courses and finished it. Now that's a great feeling. So having this public references can help tremendously. All the recruiters I have talked to loved it because, of course, it's easier for them to convince potential employers for an interview. And come on, as an ambitious developer like you, I'm sure you have some unfinished side projects lying on your hard disk just collecting dust. Finish them and show them to the world. Just imagine a side project you've done during school or during an internship becomes a huge success. The right employer who sees that doesn't care about any degree. They already know that you've got what it takes. So decide for yourself. A degree can be a ticket into the tech industry, and it may provide some security if times look badly. But it costs you several years and maybe even money up front, unfortunately. But then again, it can be some kind of investment into yourself and into your future. Going another way might not be so secure, but you have the opportunity to get into the industry earlier and develop the skill you want to have without all that other stuff. It really is up to you. Sorry. One additional side note. If you want to become some kind of entrepreneur and build your own project, your own app, your own stuff in essence, you don't need any of that. Just do it. Okay, that's it. So I hope this helped. Please write your comments and also your questions about this topic if you have any below. And if you like that video, please press the like button. And as always, please subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching. Take care and happy coding.